Hello friends, welcome back to Civil Engineering Mastery. In the previous video, we had discussed about how to calculate the column loads by using influence area method. Today, in this video, we are going to model the same G+2 building in StatPro software and let us compare the results of manual method and StatPro analysis. So friends, now we are going to model the G+2 building in StatPro software without importing from AutoCAD file. Now go to geometry, run structural wizard. Here in the model type, you have to select frame models, bay frame, double click on that. So we got the parameters, length, height, width, and number of bays along length, number of bays along height, number of bays along width. So now we have to enter all these values to get our frame. Let's see in the framing plan. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4 bays in the width direction and 1, 2, 3, 4 bays in the length direction as well. So these values I have converted into meters. So we have to enter these values in the StatPro parameters to get the frame. So here we are going to enter the length value. The total of the length value is 10.14. So whatever we have seen in the AutoCAD drawing, there were 4 bays, right? So we have to add all those 4 bays and we have to enter the total value in the length direction. Height, we are going to consider, first we are going to take only one floor. So I'm entering 3 meter, which is the floor height, and in the width direction also we had 4 bays and the total of 4 bays is 7.862. So here number of bays along length is 4 and number of bays along height we are going to consider only 1 4 now, and number of bays along width is also 4 bays. So here we have to enter the values. The length direction 3.51 and next one is 2.21, next one is 0.91, and again along the width direction 0.762, 1.07, 2.28, 3.75. Give OK, apply. So we got the frame. Close this one. So give S. Okay, so we got the model here. Now let us delete the unwanted beams and columns. Okay, so let's turn this side so it is easy for us to make the frame. So here if you see that here is the framing plan. So if you see here, there are 3 columns in the first row. So what we have to do here is these 3 are the columns which we have. Oh, I'm sorry, these 3. 1, 2, 3. So we have to delete off these 2 columns and along with the beams. And again we are having in the next row we are having this column, so this also we have to delete, this also will not be there. This column we are having here, this is the one, and again we have to delete this and this. We don't have this column as well. And here coming to this row, 1, 2, 3 we have. So this center column we have, and these two we don't have. So we have to delete. Okay, now we got all the columns, 12 columns in the first grid, 3 columns, and second only one column, and third it is 2 column, and again in the fourth 1, 2, 3 columns, and again in the fifth there are 3 columns. Now let's arrange the beams. So first here one beam is there, you can see beam 2, so we need to add that beam here. So Control C, Control V. We are entering in the, it is in the X direction. So we can see the distance from this center to beam center. So I'm taking from here 6 feet 2 inches, and again the 4 inches we have to add for the beam center. So it is 6 feet 6 inches. So minus, we have to enter in the downward direction. So minus 1.98, that is 6 feet 6 inches. So we got that beam. And again, if you see here in this slab, there is no beam. So we can merge all these beams, go to geometry, merge selected members, give merge. And again here, also we have to merge the beams. Next, we have to delete this beam. So here there is no beam in this area. And again, if you see here, this beam is little bit moved away from the column. So that distance we have to measure, and we have to so it is 10 inches plus beam center 4 inches. So it is around 1 feet 2 inches. So that comes around 0.35. Control C, Control V. 0.35. So we got that beam, and there is no need of this beam here. We can delete that, and then again merge beams. So almost here we got the same frame as in the AutoCAD drawing, and this is the staircase portion. And here also we have to merge the beams. And again here, this beam we have to move little further. So we got that beam here. This one we can delete. And again this beam we have to merge. So finally we got the actual framing plan which we have in the AutoCAD file. Okay, so we can cross check it. Now we have to add this cantilever slab over here, which is 3 feet length, that we have to add here. Copy, paste in the X direction. 3 feet is 0.9 meter. Okay. And we can add beams over here. And then we can merge. So now we are done with the ground floor roof frame. Next, we have to do the first floor roof frame. So for that, we need to select all this and then go to translational repeat. Here, Y direction, our floor height is 3 meter. Give OK. Select the first floor roof. Give Alt BV. Now we can change this frame according to the first floor roof frame. Okay, so here what we have to do is there is no beam over here, so we can delete this beam and then we can merge. Go to geometry, merge selected member, and this also we can merge. Now what we have to do here is, here we have to add this beam. So let's see the dimension from the center line to here is 4 feet 8 inches. So we have to add 4 inches for again beam center line. So it is 5 feet. We have to select this, copy and paste in the x direction, minus 1.52, which is 5 feet. So we got this beam here. And again, there is no beam over here in this column. So this we can delete. Next, we have to add this beam. So you can see this is starting from this column. So we can add the beam by using, go to geometry, add beam. We can add T beam. So select from here to here. So it is perpendicular now. So we have added this beam and this beam. Okay, so now we have to change this beam over here. So it is starting from this column. Again, we can delete this. Go to geometry, add beam, T beam. So from this node to perpendicular direction, we can add one beam. So now we can select this beam, give merge, and again. So now first floor roof frame is also done. So now we have to add the cantilever portion. Already we have added one cantilever portion over here, and again this side there is one more cantilever slab, so that one we have to add. So that is starting from this column. So what we have to do here is, so we have added the cantilever portion and we can join the beams. We can delete this and then add beam. We can delete these nodes. We can add on beam here. Now we are done with first floor roof framing plan. So now we know that these two are typical floor. So what we can do here is we can do translational repeat. Y direction 3 meter is the floor height. So now we got all the three floors. So friends, we are done with framing plan for all the three floors. Now we are going to do the finite element analysis. For that we have to add the plate elements. Plate, beam, slab concept we are using here. So let's add the plate elements and then let's assign the member properties. So friends, here I have done with plate elements for all the three floors. If you want to know about the step-by-step procedure for how to make the plate elements, please refer my playlist. I had already uploaded one detailed video about how to make the plate elements for G+1 building. The link is also given in the description box. Please refer that link. So friends, I hope you all understood about how to model the building in StatPro software without importing from the AutoCAD file. And let's continue the same model, like assigning the loads, assigning the member properties and support conditions in the next part of this series. Please do comment in the comment box. Thank you for watching.